Hey, what's up? It's your boy Reflect. Welcome to Sinners and Saints with your boy Change. Now make sure you stay tuned for my testimony interview. Might change your life. Peace.
Hey, Minister Change.
Brother Al, at your service. Oh, God.
From Sinner to Saints, this podcast of truth, you is or you ain't. Let's break down the facts. Yeah. It's Minister Change, Minister Change. Sinner to Saints, this podcast of truth, you is or you ain't. Let's break down the facts. It's Minister Change, it's Minister Change. Sinner to Saints, this podcast of truth, you is or you ain't. Let's break down the facts. It's Minister Change, you know where we at. You know where we at.
My name is Quantre, I'm 11 years old, and I want everyone to accept Jesus into their life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Greetings, 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 vessels of the Most High. It's time to crusade with Minister Change on the podcast, Change of Life, Testimonies from Sinners to Saints. Life is a testimony. God is good all the time. Be thankful for today. Let tomorrow take care of itself. Amen, 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 amen. I'd like to welcome my guest, Reflect, to the podcast, Change of Life Testimonies from Sinner to Saints. What's going on, man of God? Tell me how you feeling tonight.
Hey, what's up, Minister Change? I'm blessed to be here tonight.
Hey, man, most definitely, man. Hey, man, we're going to start this interview off, man. What you telling the people, man, where you from? Where was you born and raised?
Yeah, I was actually born in Newport, Rhode Island, but when I was real young, I moved down to Woodbridge, Virginia. That's like 20 minutes south of D.C.
Okay, brother. Okay. Good deal. Good deal. Hey, brother, I know you got to have, man, a favorite Bible scripture that you like to go to, man, in a time of distress.
No, absolutely, man. It's probably one of the most audacious and has so much audacity to say, and that's 2 Corinthians 5:17. It states, therefore, if any man or woman be in Christ, is a new creation, the old is gone and the new has come. That's the one that really sticks out to me, man, because for so long I lived one way, and then it was brought to my attention that that was the wrong way to live, and I had to change my life, and he gave me a new life, a new opportunity. So, yeah.
Amen, amen, brother. I call that taking off them grave clothes, putting on them praise clothes. Because God knows what's good. God already knows our future. Hey, brother, if somebody was to ask you about your character, how would you define yourself?
Oh, man. Free-spirited. Always down to make and meet new people. I would have to say one of the things that I really try to work on is integrity. Amen. You know, it's about how you act when you're alone with God, with making those decisions. That's the most important. That's what sticks out to me is doing the right thing when you know the difference between the right and wrong thing.
Amen, amen, brother. Amen, that's good. That's good, Reflect. Hey, brother, and that just leads on into the next question, man. If you had to create a list of morals and values, what would be your top three things?
Yeah. That's good, man. That's good. So look, for so long, I didn't know that there was a truth and principle to living. And in Galatians chapter 5, it specifically talks about the fruits of the spirit and the deeds of the flesh.
Amen.
And the deeds of the flesh being anger, fits of rage, debauchery, all of those things combined, that's how I was living. And all it led to was disorder in my life. It was never enough. I had no connection to anything. But then I kept reading, and it said, but if you live by the Spirit is peace, patience, love, kindness, gentleness, patience, self-control. It says, with those, knowing those things, there is no law. And matter of fact, it's all love and it's all good. So when you focus on those core group of beliefs and principles and can identify those areas in your life where you need to do the contrast, you need to change. That's really what it is about for me. Peace, patience, kindness.
Amen. Yeah. Amen, brother. That's a good word, man. That was good, brother. Most definitely, we got to have those things to make it in everyday life, man. Those are most definitely very, very important, brother. Good word, good word. Hey, brother, this is the testimony moment, brother. What life event made you think, I can't do this no more, man? I need God. What made you go from sinner to saint?
Amen. I mean, there were multiple moments. Okay. See, I'm a prodigal son. I walked away.
Okay.
And when I walked away, I realized I was just walking back into his arms.
Amen.
He never gave up on me, man.
Amen.
I made my mistakes in life. No more than anybody else, right?
Amen.
But the difference is that Christ forgave me. You know, with Easter being around, I think about the thief on the cross.
Amen.
Wasn't baptized.
Amen.
Didn't have to say the sinner's prayer. Didn't have to do those things. Just said, Jesus, how do I get in? He said, you know what? Just believe. Just believe. And I can't help but remember the time that I was 26. I had been living a life of my own free will, sinning willfully, I guess, from about 16 to 26. And I was presented with an opportunity to change my life and go into Teen Challenge. And that's a place, it's a ministry for those who are struggling with life-controlling issues.
Amen.
And it was also a discipleship ministry. And when they presented that scripture, 2 Corinthians 5:17, I was intrigued, like that I could wash this slate clean and have another chance, you know?
Amen, brother, amen.
And so when that happened, I would say about 26, to put an age on it.
Amen. Man, brother, that's good, man. It's when you think about the goodness of God, man, and you know the forgiveness and that no matter what we've been through, we can always turn to him. And he has those open arms to embrace us and bring us back into his path. Hmm. Hey, brother, what do you think? What is the best thing about being a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, man?
Well, a lot of people think that it's boring and that, you know, we just sit around and sing hymns and, you know, and sit by the fire. No, man, Christian life is an active thing. It's a practice. Every day I realize I can wake up with a new opportunity to bless somebody with love instead of hate.
Amen.
In fact, just the other day I was driving, I got cut off. Lo and behold, you know, I'm driving on 2-lane road. Lo and behold, I hit a red light, and the guy that cut me off, I have to pull up next to him, right? So I see him, and he's looking at me to respond in anger. But instead, I just waved and said, hey, man, no problem.
Amen.
And to see his face melt with love, that's what it's about. And I believe that's what we need to do. It's not just, man, it's about the goodness and knowing that we can dictate our day. Instead of letting somebody else dictate us.
Amen.
You know?
Amen, brother. That's good, because what a lot of people don't know and they don't understand, but if you are a believer, you do understand. Once you come to the Lord Jesus Christ, you get a humbleness in your heart. And that humbleness, it overcomes all that anger sometimes and the stuff that you had. When somebody would have cut you up in the past, you probably would have gave them the finger and been ready to fight. But now you're like, wait a minute, I'm not even doing that no more. It's not worth it.
No.
God has transformed me, brother. That was a good one, brother. That was a good one. Hey, brother, do you think, man, your childhood environment, man, played a major part in your life?
I do, yeah.
Okay. So was it a good upbringing, or what was the part that stood out that you think that you have with you still today?
So one of the things that God blessed me with was a good family.
Okay.
And they never gave up on me.
Amen.
Even when I looked away and ran away, my mom never stopped praying.
Amen.
And you know, God will put people in your path.
Yes.
To guide you to the place he wants you to be. And man, right now I'm at a church called Broken Chains. It's in Taunton, Massachusetts, and it's changed my life. There's a freedom that I haven't had in so long.
Amen, brother. Man, brother, that's good, man. That's good.
That's good, man.
Man,
that's... the best thing is that it's not just for me. That there's no favorites in the kingdom. We're all his kids. The same stuff that he wants to do for me, he wants to do for you. You
Amen.
Know? You just got to ask.
Amen. Amen, brother. Most definitely, brother. Hey, brother, reflect. Have you figured out, man, the assignment that God has for you on this earth?
Each day is different.
Okay.
I can have an idea of what's going to happen, but most of the time it never happens that way.
Okay.
And I guess what he wants me to do and what I feel my mission is right now is just show the love of Christ.
Amen.
You know, God gave me a gift, and that's the spoken word and hip hop and the love of music, you know, and, you know, everybody wants to make a career out of music. That would be, you know, a dream of mine, but that's not really what it's about. It's just for an opportunity. Like this, like I hope my music provides this because it's only about the testimony.
Amen.
Anybody can sing. A
Amen.
Bird can make you, right?
Amen, brother. Amen.
It's all about the testimony.
And that's what I tell people. I said, your true talent is your testimony because your testimony is what changed lives.
Yes.
Somebody hearing you, there's somebody out there right now on this podcast that's going to be blessed, brother. Because they have went through, there's so many things in your life that is similar to their life. And now, by you releasing it, they are releasing it with you. And now it
Amen.
Gives them the opportunity, brother, to move on.
You know, definitely, brother. The enemy is tricky.
Yes.
Once you make a mistake, he'll tell you that you can't go back. That there's no way they're going to accept you and play tricks on your mind, making you think that you can't go back to Christ.
Yes.
But the thing is that he's always right there.
Amen. Amen, brother. Amen. And once we know that, man, we know that no matter what, no matter what we're going through, brother, we can get down on our knees and we can pray and we can turn to our Lord, Savior, Jesus Christ, brother.
Yeah. And we can change the day just like that.
Amen,
with
amen.
The power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen, amen. Hey, brother, Reflect, I want you to finish this sentence for me. God has always
been there for me.
Give me one time in your life that you knew that God had came through for you and he was there for you.
Sure. So, 2006, I was diagnosed with Crohn's disease. Okay. I think I had it for a long time, but I never was diagnosed with it. I never could put a label on what was going on. And when things start to go wrong in the natural, it's really hard to trust the spiritual. You know what I'm saying? And I was in a situation where the Crohn's disease had narrowed my descending colon from the infections over the years, and they needed to take it out. And when they did the surgery, this is in Boston Medical Center, I'm in the hospital, I'm in fifth day there, I'm getting ready to go the next day, and they had advanced my diet too quick, and it ruptured my intestines in my body. And I became septic, and I almost died. I was in the hospital for 35 days. I lost 80 pounds.
Man.
And I didn't think that I was going to make it, man.
Oh,
I really didn't. And I had my trial of dependence on pain medicine to take away all of that. And what I realized after so many times of going to surgeries and coming out of it and being sick and in the hospital, when I got down on my knees, because I had had it, I was done, man.
Amen.
I had had it and literally had to cry out because I could not take the weight anymore.
Amen.
And it wasn't like overnight. It was like, you know, boom. But slowly and surely, by my staying the course, right, staying the course and believing and trusting and staying connected, that was the main thing, staying connected to other believers. Amen. He's brought me out of it.
Amen.
Brought me out of it. Now,
amen.
You know, I have my bad days, but who doesn't? That's life.
Amen. It's
you know?
Life. We all
He's given us the power to overcome those things.
Amen. Amen, brother. That's a good
and
testimony.
I wouldn't have known this. Let me interrupt you, and I'm sorry, but no. I wouldn't have known this if I didn't go through the stuff that I went through. See what I'm saying? So I'm blessed. It was horrible. It was rough. But at the end of the day, I'm blessed because of what I learned and can tell somebody else that's going through something, that you just got to hold on, stay the course, and stay connected, man.
Amen. Amen, brother. That's good, man. And that right there strengthens your faith. The trials and tribulations that we go through strengthens our faith because it gets to a point where there's nobody but you, me, and God. There's just a one-on-one with God. And once you get that one-on-one with God, it's just the trust in your faith is building because you have no other option.
I got no other option, man.
No other option, brother. Just that one-on-one with God.
That's the best option.
Yeah, most definitely, most definitely, most definitely. Because you got, it's like, God, you know, God, we're going to have to work together. I know I ain't been, but we're going to have to work this out. Because I'm, you know, we're going to have to work this
out. I'm here, man.
Most definitely. Most definitely, brother. Good word, good word. Yeah. Hey, brother, I got a question for you, man. And I like to ask this question, man. How important, man, is life insurance to you, brother?
Life insurance?
Yes.
Well, like insurance on life?
Yes, yes. Like, say a life insurance. So, say if we happen to pass away, man, how important is life insurance of having a policy?
I mean, what are you saying? For, like, my loved ones? Like, for
yes,
my
yes,
loved
yes,
ones?
Yes, 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 yes. For, like, say when you passed away or somebody passed away. Because, I mean, a lot of times, man, I see people, they do GoFundMes when people pass away. And then a lot of times they don't even get the money they need. And it kind of makes it hard on the family when they're relying on another source of income to bury their loved one and the way that they would love them to be buried. So I was just wondering you, I always ask people, how important is life insurance?
Look, you know, Proverbs 3, chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and to lean not on your own understanding, but to acknowledge him in every way, and he shall lead your path straight. To say it is one thing. Anybody can just say it. I can say those words.
Amen.
But the situation is bigger than the words sometimes. But then God intercedes and intervenes and provides situations like life insurance,
amen,
policies, stuff like that.
Amen.
So, yeah, I believe in them. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Amen. If there's an opportunity that you can get it, yeah, for sure.
Amen. Amen, brother. Amen. Hey, brother, what is a positive word of encouragement, man, you could give to anybody hurt, man, any person right now, man, that say, I just want to give up, man. I don't want to live no more. Brother, what is some words that you can give them to lift their spirit?
Well, I've been there. I know what they're feeling. And to be blunt, it sucks. It's a very bad feeling. And I want to encourage them that this is only a season and this too shall pass.
Amen.
And if they're a believer, I want them to know that Christ is still there. It says when we give up, he gives in.
Amen.
God sent Jesus to expose religion and to impose a relationship. And
amen.
In that relationship, in those struggles, in those hard times, that's where Christ is going to show up. If you're watching, if you're looking, if you're asking.
Amen. Amen. Most definitely, brother. Most definitely. Hey, brother, let's talk a little bit about your musical gift, man. Can you tell the people a little bit about your musical gift, man?
Sure.
Give them some handles, some contact information. If somebody want to contact you and want to reflect with Reflect and get together and do that and get something going on.
Absolutely.
And give them some little info, brother.
Yeah, so check it out, man. I'm just starting to go public with the music. I traveled around to different churches for a couple years now and in the past as well. But anyway, long story short, I love to do live shows. Matter of fact, I got a show coming up. I'll get the details on the plug. But for right now, you can reach me at he is reflect Instagram, reflect at reflect at YouTube, at reflect at Spotify, at reflect, all those good things. And you can check me out. Yeah.
Amen. Amen, brother. Hey, brother, before we end this podcast, brother, I want to give you this blessing assurance. It's free. It's what God give to us, brother. So I just wonder, brother, if you could repeat this prayer for me so I'll know that you will have this blessing assurance when you leave the podcast, brother.
I am always available for a blessing. Amen.
Amen. Amen, brother. So repeat after me, man. Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I know I'm a sinner.
I know that I'm a sinner.
I believe you died for my sins.
And I believe you died for my sins.
Right now, at this moment, I turn from my sins.
Right now, at this moment, I'm going to turn from my sins.
And I open the door of my heart and life to you.
And I open the door to my heart and my life to you.
I confess that you are my personal Lord and Savior.
I confess that you are my personal Lord and Savior.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, 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 brother. Man, we prayed that prayer. Now we know we both going to be kicking it in heaven.
We're both going to be kicking it in heaven.
We're going to be talking about this interview.
I was just telling my family, man, hey, look, I see everything going on in the world. It gets me excited. It doesn't shoot me fear. I'm excited. You know why? Because I'm going home.
Amen. Amen, brother. Hey, brother, man, I'd like to thank you, man, for fellowshipping, man, with your boy Change. I mean, on the Change of Life testimonies from Center to Saints, man. Hey, I just want you to continue praying for me, brother. And I'm going to continue praying for you, man. God's blessings, man. Just keep your spirit up.
Hey, we got to connect. Oh, real quick. I see you know my friend Jonah Nathan.
Yeah.
Big ups to Jonah Nathan, man.
Yeah, most definitely.
He and I used to do shows together all the time.
Okay. Yeah, we're gonna be connecting, brother. We most definitely going to be connecting.
Cool. All right. Hey, man, be blessed.
All right, Brother Sam, to you. God blessings.
God bless. Peace.
That was my man, Reflect. Hey, y'all, that interview was really touching. I hope it hit somebody's heart and brought somebody a positive change in their life. Hey, I want y'all to sit back, get relaxed, get ready to vibe to this hot track from a man, Reflect. Let's get it. God is good all the time. Amen.
What's up, dog?
How you doing?
How you doing? How you been? Haven't seen you for a while. See, you still living in sin. I used to be that cat too with drugs on my side. Ready to go, ready to die. I often think about the past, how I drove so fast just to slow down. Used to roll around town smoking on them brown paper leaves. Clouds out the window, running from police. I was trapped in the fire. Then I met him and he switched my desire. Now I testify, the Lord heard my cry. If I die, now I know I'll fly to that sky. But who's coming with me at any cost? I'm here to reach the lost from the day of Pentecost. To set the tone so we won't be tossed into eternal flames. Not playing games, does he know your name? 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. What I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah. 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. Lord, I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah. On a different level, I could see the devil in the eyes of many men, high on medicine. Trapped in the days, lost in the maze. On the way to hell's blaze, let's stop and pray. Patience is a virtue, being anxious will hurt you. calling him and to begin to search you and set you free from that sin that you bleed. Cause who he sets free is free indeed. Let's take a moment and focus what's at hand. Time is just a moment, man, a grain of sand. But if you vibe into the song, it was already planned. For the righteousness you firmly stand. United we are, divided we fall. Many are chosen, only few are called. If you receive this breath, this life you breathe. Descendants of the parents named Adam and Eve. 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. Lord, I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah. 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. Lord, I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah. Sign of the times, apocalyptic battlefield in your mind. I see a Satan, get thee behind. No longer blind, leading the blind in these times. Now I came to expose wolves in sheep's clothes. Should everyone would know the games that they show, things that they do to have us misconstrued. So what you gonna do? The choice is up to you. Now you could choose the wrong side and be gone in a minute. Blacked out tenant, pushed to the limit, deep in it, and never turning back. Another victim of the game, never be the same and forever lose your name. Or you could choose a light side, suffer no more pain. Conscious free mind, nowhere to put the blame. So join us as we stand in the gap. Remember, it's not where you're from, dog, it's where you at. 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. Lord, I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah. 7:23 on the dot, I'm on my block. Lord, I wish I could stop, but I can't. Cause this world keeps calling me. Cause this world keeps calling me, yeah.
Yeah, man, Romans 7:23 says there's a war going on inside. A battle of good and evil. I guess what I wanna ask you is, what's inside you?
It's your boy, Change, from the podcast Center to Saints. I'd like to thank you for fellowshipping with me, man, on the podcast. If anybody out there want to give their testimony, your testimony is your talent. I want you to hit me up at change, C-H-Y-A-N-G-E .totten at gmail.com. Once again, that's change.totten at gmail.com. Submit your pic, your bio, your contact info, and I will be getting back with you, man, ASAP, so you can share your testimony with the world to change somebody's life. Also, my contact number is 260-203-6655. You can hit your boy up with a text or even give me a call, and I'll make sure I'll get back with you, because we all have a testimony that can change somebody's life. Understand me. God is good. I want to say it once again, man. Keep supporting me. Keep lifting me up, because it's real important that I spread God's word to his people. God's blessing.